to stream some more. Okay, 2K16 server isn't working. I'm here to stream some more to do 2K16. So it's taken me so long. I'm very busy with work, and I've recently bought a new television, so I've been setting up, making sure it's all fine. So I've not had much time, but I'm back. And here we go. Let's stream some new WWE Universe. Now, if you remember last time, the last thing we did was have an match between Undertaker and Sting for the WWE Championship at SummerSlam, and as you can see right there, Undertaker became the new WWE Champion. Now, I've decided. Not to do any match on Raw or SmackDown for the benefit of me only streaming an hour. I can't fit Night of Champ or you know, pay per view and do match on Raw and SmackDown all in an hour, and I only want to stream an hour. And I want to try and get a pay per view in every stream I do. So the next pay per view is Night of Champions, and that is where we're going to be having. So let me just check the current library. So as you can see, the current library is Sting, Undertaker, The Shield vs Christian Avenge, and Samoa Joe vs Daniel Bryan. We'll need some more rivalries here, so Kalisto, who I'm going to have to retain again, can go against. Who can we have this time? We need a bit of competition. We're going to have who? So that's fitting into just our library. You know what I'm gonna do? I got the Hall of Fame DLC, I downloaded it. I already had the season pass, so it was a matter of just like downloading it. I'm sorry if you can see my cat in the corner there, but you know, it's not doing anything. My cat's always in my room. I open the door, he shoots in, so not much I can do, but anyway, here we go. Customize the universe, have some stars. So it was just run the blades. Show. Who else was in this? Booker T 96. No, we'll keep the current Booker T. The Heart is empty off the end. Butch. Dustin Rhodes, no, I prefer Goldust. Earthquake. Earthquake. No. Oh, no. I don't know fully who's in the Hall of Fame pack, so you'll have to give me a second to look through them. I try and be as quick as I can, so I know this must be boring to watch. I do need to actually check in. I always have my stream there so I can see when it goes down. If it goes down. On. He was new, but most of it was Kunlock. How has he got more hair there? Unless I want it. That looks like a younger Rock than that one. Makes no fucking sense. So in 2002, he didn't have all the tattoos there on the right. Interesting to know, because that's what he did. Let me just check Kevin Nash, because I'm sure there's another Kevin Nash now. Yeah, Kevin Nash 96. Kevin Nash. What's the current? One of my heroes is on the news. I can't be bothered. Destined for greatness. What is this trophy? Give me a second, I just want to check my trophy. You can only hear me now. Just for a second. Come on. Stack both momentum and hot streak statuses to 10 through the gameplay or simulation. Right. Back to that. Right. What should I do first? I'm going to get into content for this time. We'll get rid of that mouse because I don't want to do that. Big match. I'm going to the tag team match because I have one first. But let's do that. Okay, let's kick off with this match. The Shield versus Edge and Christian. Now, if you watched my last stream, you remember that I accidentally simulated this match at SummerSlam, and Edge and Christian became the world tag team champions. That was what was happening. But I don't want to lose. I don't want to keep Edge and Christian as the champions. I don't want to defeat.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the WWE Tag Team Championship. Introducing first, Dean Ambrose and Roman Reigns, The Shield.
The combination of these two competitors looks nearly unstoppable.
There's no denying that this is a tremendous tag team combination. Reminds me of the old APA.
Champions, Christian and Edge.
four of WWE's finest, squaring off in what will assuredly be an exciting tag team encounter. Oh man, I'm really looking forward to this tag team match. So much anticipation, and it all comes down to this. Ambrose and his tag team partner look ready for action. Here we go. The tag team scene here in WWE is undergoing a bit of a renaissance, and it's
before, and I know that just popped up. That view is me because I've got it going. Before I carry on, let me just show you my new TV, if you're interested. So you'll be seeing my room a bit now. Look at this TV. As you can see, you can't really... So, yeah, look at this TV. I love it. Anyway, sorry. There we are. Right, let's continue. Sorry.
Because of action like this. This is undoubtedly the chance of a lifetime for Dean Ambrose.
It's not wise to get on the bad side of a man like Dean Ambrose.
Covers, and he escapes with a kick out. Dean Ambrose is not going to go away that easy. And he gets leveled. You know, sometimes newer superstars need a little time to get comfortable with their surroundings before they really make a name for themselves. But not Christian. This guy won the light heavyweight championship in his first match here in the WWE. And he just keeps getting better with time. And he finally gets out of the ring. Man, the impact of that kick sounded awful. But I assure you, it hurt even worse.
That's my reason if anybody's on the show, but isn't it hard to tell a story, does it? When you feel something, when you watch it, when you're
a singles title doesn't gain you instant entry into the Hall of Fame, but it sure gets you a whole heck of a lot closer.
Since that light heavyweight championship victory you brought up earlier, Christian has gone on to accomplish some amazing feats here in WWE, including revolutionizing the tag team scene with his partner Edge. Their TLC matches in the early 2000s were so historic.
Yeah, but Michael, Christian isn't just a tag team specialist. Here's a guy who's won nearly every single title there is to win in the WWE, including the World Heavyweight Championship when he beat Alberto Del Rio for the title in a wild ladder match in May of 2011.
Wow, Edge just timed that perfectly. Reigns sit down hard.
Let's see.
It should be black and blue after this.
I'd have to say WWE 2016 is probably the best WWE game of the last kind of 5 years, because ever since the name was...
It's an amazing... And that was a costly misstep. What makes Roman Reigns such a lethal entity is he possesses the power to dominate an opponent of any size, the athleticism to add speed to his attack, and a ferocity that makes him a relentless instrument of destruction.
Well, there's no doubt about it, Cole. Roman Reigns' abilities, the strength, the agility, and his unyielding intensity really makes him a devastating weapon. How much damage did that do? A lot, from the looks of it.
You know, in NHL games when they were making them great, you know, great at making them.
Edge is one of the most successful competitors WWE has ever known. Yeah. He's the ultimate opportunist and someone who can adapt under any conditions in or out of the ring. We'll see now if his endurance can hold.
Empower DDT! Ooh, that's ugly! We've seen Roman Reigns. Hey, the shoulders are down!
NW2K15 came out, I kind of, like, I got the PSV version of it.
The more punishment he takes, the slower and slower he is getting back to his feet.
Detail, I thought, maybe because 2K15 was the first wrestling game on next-gen. They focused more on next-gen than they did on next-gen, so I thought, okay, fair enough.
The challengers are going to have to dig down deep if they have to walk out of here with the titles wrapped around their waist.
Because I got the DTA.
This guy's just getting worn out.
To be the first PS4 game I found, but the first get separate game I bought was WWE 15, because I heard this about my career.
He's seen it up. Here he comes, and it's Edge able to break free. Roman Reigns buries his assumption, but he always brings it back to his power game. The effect of his speed, agility, and crushing strikes on an opponent are all intensified because there is such brute force behind everything he hits you with.
He's doing everything he can to get his bearings back here, otherwise this match could be over sooner than anyone could have anticipated.
Yeah, Cole, this is when you have to settle things down. Get the blood flowing back in your body and strategize what your next move or your next
The shoulders are down! And he might have to do this by himself.
Wow, there's the save. The match continues.
Out of nowhere!
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Better match selection.
Work is being put in by Roman Reigns. Look at him, Michael. Those moves have really started to add up. You know, to be great in this business, sometimes it's as easy as being in the right place at the right time. And few people know that better than Edge. He's made a career out of capitalizing on others' misfortunes. Heck, that's why they call him the ultimate opportunist. Looks like somebody wants back in this match.
Taking it to the chest here.
I knew it couldn't be any worse than 2K15 because it would probably be one of the worst WWE games.
The championship hangs in the balance.
And it could fall at any moment. This is a great matchup, Cole. Who's going to win this championship?
Edge is one of the most successful competitors WWE has ever known.
That's it. He's done. He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going now.
And now he's back out on the apron.
I hope I'm going to pick this at 17. There's not many things missing from this game.
These guys giving this sold-out crowd exactly what they came to see. What an incredible match.
One of the light to be added into the WWE 17. Well, you know. I think that's something I'd like to come back and really do this team is
these guys are giving it their all here tonight, not just to entertain the fans, but to ultimately walk away with the win.
The first year was failing.
Expanding the repertoire with that move.
Incredible. It's amazing what happens when a competitor channels all their ability in one move. You get high octane offense like that.
But, you know,
he's in bad shape. He's got to make the tag. And a strike connects. And Dean Ambrose gets taken down.
Yeah, you know what? I think that one hurt his pride just as much.
But since then, really.
And wow, what a collision!
That spear may have done it. An early pin attempt. Come on, Rip. Count.
Oh. This is hard.
He gets the tag.
Just taking the injury kind of way. Unlike last
There's
year.
There's clearly something about his face that he doesn't like. Yeah, the same way I feel about yours.
Was the fact that he was going to run for a phone out of charge. My phone's running out of charge. One thing that pissed me off, another thing that pissed me off about that game was just check how long, 20 minutes, was the fact. Is that charging? Yeah, it is. When someone was injured, which was a very, very rare occasion, you'd be in a match, right? You'd complete them.
We're looking at complete domination here.
You get, oh, such and such is returned. I remember clearly was very mysterious when it was a different team. I mean, it clearly won the theory because.
Remember, in championship matches, the title cannot change hands by count out or disqualification. Yeah, that's why they call it the championship advantage. You can lose the match, but keep it.
Just let me check his. Okay, Frog Splash reverse TV.
There he goes again! And again! And again! And again! Watch out!
And here he comes. You can never count Dean Ambrose out. We know he's a lunatic fringe. We know there's no...
The arm trap cross-leg STF. That'll do it. That's the longest name in the history. Arm trap cross-leg STF.
I remember clearly when we said in theory
the shoulders plenty of fight left. You're right, this guy's still near 100%. And frustration continues to build as Christian refuses to stay down. He's setting up.
And it was like, oh, Rome's Theory has returned. Has he?
Oh, nice counter. Oh, wait, nice reversal. Christian through the switch. They call this could do it.
I think so.
He might have to do this, but he got it. Oh,
there
were some unbelievable highlights. Watch this.
Yeah, okay. Has he? You know, he wasn't actually.
You want to talk about incredible high-impact sports entertainment?
Check out what happened during this match. After a match and returned. And you never knew when it was going to happen, so it was kind of like really like a surprise. The only problem with this
was like,
you know, the person that injured them, they wouldn't return after their match or whatever, so like, you turn and like, look, I'm going to be coming for you, kind of thing. It would be just like a random match after random match, and then they return. That was the only downfall of it. But like in 2K15, on the rare occasion that they were injured, it was always awesome. Oh, they return.
Oh, they threw everything they had at each other in this match.
Here are your winners and still the WWE Tag Team Champions, Christian and Edge.
I love a good tag team match, and this one was unforgettable. I mean, these teams gave us everything they had, and the WWE versus the true winner in this one. And don't forget, you and I, we had the best seats in the house.
And in 2K17, there's no need for another career mode. They already accomplished what they needed to do with the career mode in this. They made it brilliant in this. They made it a hell of a lot better than they did in 2K17. There's not much more they can do with my career mode. Instead of just putting it in the game and repeating it from this game, there's not much more they can do that can't make it any better. Really. It was already pretty decent. But, you know, we'll see. We will see. They could leave that out and kind of put something else in there, like just leave showcase mode and um and then have some different kind of mode. Because like in 2K14, you had Universe Mode, Showcase Mode, or Showcase Mode, and you also had in the Showcase bit, there was also the streak thing that you could do. So we had three different things you could do. And it's always good to have three different things you can do in a WWE game. So you've got your Universe Mode, which is going to be in the next game. You've got your Showcase Mode, which is going to be in the next game. And then you've got to find different kind of things for them to do. I don't know what it could be, but do not make it My Career Again. Do make it something else. Something that doesn't take up as much room, so you can focus more on Universe Mode. I mean, if you made Universe Mode good enough, you wouldn't need a third mode, you just need Showcase Mode and you need a Universe Mode. If you made the storytelling in Universe Mode and put a lot more effort into Universe Mode, you wouldn't need a third thing to do on the game, because you'd have online as well, and for a lot of people that'd be enough. Anyway, next match. Christian has successfully defended the WWE Tag Team Championship in their championship rematch. Okay, so we'll do. This is the kind of order we're going to do it. We're going to do a Women's Championship match, and then we're going to do the United States Championship match. Then we're going to do the Intercontinental Championship match, and we're going to do the rivalry match, and then finally the WWE World Heavyweight Championship match. Let's get crack on with it, because I want to try and fit all of them. If I go over 10 minutes, fine. I'm not fussed, I don't really want to get all the matches done, so that's going to the Women's Championship match. This should be it, because I think the last four pay-per-views, these two have been going at it, so this should be the last one. To be honest, I don't know who, I'm kind of stuck at who I want. Sorry, let me just move my foot. I'm kind of stuck at who I want, who I want to defeat the first half.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the WWE Women's Championship.
It's an extra small room and have someone take it off, but I don't know. Remember the Blaze. I'm so glad I remember the Blaze in this game, because that's who's going to take it off.
Representing the Bella Twins, from Scottsdale, Arizona, Nikki Bella.
I don't know if you know about Nikki Bella, but she had some good news. You've probably seen it if you're Twitter. She's healing like a superwoman, as it said. It's funny that is, because her boyfriend, Tom Cena, feels like Superman. Unfortunately, his hope to be back for WrestleMania doesn't look like it's going to be happening, because if it was going to happen, it would have happened by now, like the Undertaker to John Cena, that would have been set up by now, but now Undertaker's going to get Shane McMahon, so. Hang on.
And her opponent,
sorry,
from Sanford, North Carolina. She is the WWE Women's Champion, Lita!
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest divas of all time is on her way to the ring.
Yeah, looks and skill in equal measure. One of the great divas of all time, Lita.
I wouldn't be surprised if we crown a new Women's Champion here tonight, Michael.
Even though Nikki Bella is one of my favorite divas, gonna have her beat my favorite diva of all time.
Man, social media is abuzz with the outcome of this match, and the WWE Universe seems to be torn on a favorite.
Just to kind of update you on the Uncharted.
And there's the bell! Oh, Michael, this is going to be fun to watch!
I think I've done either 5 or 6 parts.
Put out the laundry, because the clothesline is here!
Oh, man, that almost took the head off!
I really do, because I want to get all the Uncharted 1, 2, 3 completed before 4 comes out. I'm streamed.
This one's about the Women's Championship, and nothing means more to these divas than that title.
You're right. Every one of these divas want that title.
If you're taking up shots to the back of the head sooner or later, you're going to be seeing stars.
Yeah, or at least looking up at the lights. Nikki Bella lit up television screens in 2008 when she and her sister Brie debuted in WWE. The co-creator of Twin Magic has turned heads in WWE while being a former Divas champion, the 2013 Diva of the Year, and along with her sister Brie, a reality television star on the E! Network's Total Divas show.
King, what can you tell the WWE Universe about Lita?
She, like all the Divas in WWE, is an amazing athlete, Margo. But just how amazing? I think we're going to find out tonight.
I need to make room for it. I think it's like 30 minutes. He's listening right now. We need to make room for it, so I've got room for it. But yeah, I've already pre-ordered it.
We're in the
filling
out process. Who's going to get the advantage and maintain control?
Your guess is as good as mine, Cole. You know, Cole, Nikki Bella shows the world what she's made of every week in that ring and on Total Divas. But to come back from an injury like that, one that almost ended your career, I mean, that says it all. Well, that and Twin Magic.
She has to be in pain from her neck all the way down to her tailbone.
She's going to definitely need a good masseuse, and I'm available.
It's not, you know, altogether that great. So after,
here we go again. Today, too fast.
Podcast and it will be downloading. I can doing that, the only problem from doing that is the fact that because it living just come out on the open more than all of it. Put a little machine in all of it, so I'm unsure that, you know, quite how I'm going to do that. Because what I fancy
this
doing
one's about the women's championship, and nothing means more to these divas than that title.
You're right, every one of these divas want that title. You know, since day one here in WWE, Nikki Bella has proved she is way more than a pretty face. Nikki has great agility from her days playing soccer for fast ground and air attacks, and she's not afraid to fight fire with fire, and she's definitely the power member of the Bellas.
But that's what I fancy doing, because that's. So I keep closing it. If I start playing at, like, say, half an hour, maybe, take a break around about half to finish 11, just in it to the toilet. I won't stop the stream, just in it to the toilet and get a drink.
What a wild attempt at striking your opponent. I don't know if she could have been further off the mark.
That was like a haymaker. Like she was taking that big home run swing.
I was about to 3-4 in the morning.
I've said it before, and I'll happily say it again. Nikki Bella has it all. I mean, the stunning beauty, the intelligence, speed, and toughness. The Turntable Diva is much more than just the name of a hit reality show. She appears to be extra slow regaining her base.
The second time you play through, there's no tips. You've got to do it on your own. But if you remember it from the
going to the well again.
Oh, out of nowhere!
In the third one, it's like...
Lita can turn it up anytime she wants to. Big shot to Nikki Bella.
I
don't know how much more of this kind of damage she can take.
I'm allowed to do that. I'm not sure if that can work. So...
Right on the kidneys! Well, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast!
But yeah,
one mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you can find yourself in a whirl of
hurt! But if I was going to do like it anyway, it wouldn't satisfy my needs of pain.
Oh no, she's in a bad way now. After a short run at ECW, Lita debuted at WWE alongside S.A. Rios in 2000, but it wasn't long before her high-flying moves outshined Rios.
That's right, Michael. Lita then aligned herself with a few guys that she had plenty in common with, Matt and Jeff Hardy. And Team Extreme was born.
16 to avoid that.
Inside the ring again.
Yeah, and they should be. This is where the action needs to be.
Yeah, I'll have a think about it. If you want to help me make my decision, because I am kind of struggling as to...
Avoids the impact there. Wearing down the opposition here.
As to what I'm
going
to do.
Going for the cover.
But then please do. Put it in the comments down below in this video, or tweet me. It's at
TomGames456.
Oh shit, she reversed
it. Oh, what a counter by lovely Nikki. Whoa, don't get up. Looking for the wow move from Nikki Bella. Now that's how you sweep an opponent under the carpet.
Yeah, tweet me at TomBurns456. Not today, in the comments below. Just, yeah, please.
Do I just stream for like seven hours straight? I'll never forget her first. Stephanie McMahon in August of 2000, and we all know who the special guest referee was that night.
I think, The Rock. My personal opinion, I think I'm going to stream for 7 hours straight, but we'll see. We'll see. It all depends because obviously once it gets around like half 10, 11, I can't even go to bed, so I can't be as I don't have to be completely quiet, but I can't be around, so there's a problem there. I don't know. I'll have a think about it, and as I said, if you want to try and make this decision for me or try and help me in my decision, tweet me at TomBurns456, put it in the comments below, however you want to get in contact with me, do so. Because it's a struggle for me, because the thing is, if I was off the day it came out, it wouldn't be a problem, because I could start playing at like 9 o'clock, 4 or 6 o'clock, and play it till about, well, what time?
That might have hurt her ego more than anything else.
Until about 10:30 tomorrow.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
No kidding, this is getting ugly.
And it's just going to be I think so. I might not even want to stream that long, so I might kind of get really tired around about 12-ish. I might not even stream 7 hours, I might even stream for like, oh,
man, even my head is ringing after that DDT. So I think it's gut check time. Can she do it? This may be it.
It all depends on the day, and I feel probably that's when I'm going to make this decision at the day. We'll see.
Wait a minute! She's going for it again! Yet another one for the highlight reel! I don't know how much longer she's going to be able to go!
I don't know. Because there's no way.
Oh, they're taking a risk.
The diving moonsault after that.
It's all over but the crying. Lita's on the defense, the title decisively.
You know what irritates me?
That match was incredible!
He doesn't play up any other time. When I'm not seeing it, he doesn't play up. He's just really fast. Sleeps for hours. Oh my god. Sleeps for hours while I'm playing the rules. Fucking, as soon as I started seeing it, he likes it. He says he knows that I've got a camera there. He likes to get in front of the camera, as you can see. He just likes to be interrupting.
We may be looking at the match of the year!
Really doesn't feel like that one today.
I can't believe what we saw in that match. Oh, they threw everything they had at each other in this match.
Here's your winner, and still the WWE Women's Champion, Lita.
And there's your winner, ladies and gentlemen.
Few things are more rewarding than the feeling of keeping your opponent's shoulders down for the 3 count.
Unbelievable match, guys, and everybody watching at home, thank you for joining us tonight for Night of Champions.
Great, isn't it? I've got 4 matches to do. The United States Intercontinental World match. Maybe we will have a chance. How the hell am I going to get that done in 20 minutes? I'm not skipping any. I'm doing them all. Reigning champion for 25 weeks. And see, look, it's added more weeks to the end of the fucking rivalry with Nikki Bella. There's no need. I've pretty much, you know, in a rivalry with, well, Lita's pretty much been in a rivalry with Nikki Bella since, but Payback, Extreme Rules, something like that. Ever since then, why does it need to keep adding weeks? I don't understand it. It's just more going to be like an hour and a half stream than an hour stream. I don't understand it, because when I did the last stream, my SummerSlam, where I did SummerSlam, it took me an hour and 5 minutes, because that's when I ended the stream, an hour and 5 minutes, and I'd just done the WWE Championship match. So what did I say? I was going to do the United States Championship match next, didn't I? I haven't thought this through, because it's like, do I have a cash in the Undertaker at some point? Because I haven't really thought through who am I going to have a champion after the Undertaker. That's a good idea, actually. Have Undertaker hold it to, I don't know, where are we now? So we've got Hell in a Cell, Survivor Series, TLC left. Have him hold it to like TLC, then cash in.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the United States Championship!
But this guy deserves every last boo he gets here tonight.
So much on the line here at Night of Champions.
That's why we call it Night of Champions.
No, it's not. It's not cool. Just to kill what it is, because it might look weird. It's in a water bottle, because that's what I tend to do. Because you can get more in a water bottle than you can in a glass. So that's what I tend to do. And no, I'm not. Trying to
so much anticipation, and it all comes down to this.
I'm doing this. Unfortunately, I'm not popular enough yet, or like enough. What it is, my job that I'm doing now, doing what I love it, but you know, reaching 24, which I did just a couple of days ago, it's made me think. What do I want? What do I really want to do? What would I really love to do? And the thing I've always loved to do is play video games. And
oh, this one's going to be a great match as Samoa Joe gets us started here. I can't wait.
And the Girl from Mars and you know, people have done this, but it kind of made me think. I don't know if the Girl from Mars gets paid for doing what she does.
So much on the line here tonight. Pride, respect, glory, and of course the coveted championship.
Fucking 3-4 million a year.
This is undoubtedly the chance of a lifetime for Daniel Bryan.
Being from Huntington Beach, California, you'd think Samoa Joe would be a little more laid back. But he's anything but that, if you ask me. Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. We're going to find out a lot here tonight. Head-to-head, no excuses. Let's get it on.
Please, please, you know, just keep watching my videos. What am I fucking saying? No one from YouTube.
Great move! Knocked down, what a shot!
It really would be my dream to get paid to stream games. It really would be my dream. Because I enjoy it so much.
He's still not through!
Every
single
stream.
And that's a shot that could drop a grizzly!
I watch back my first kind of stream I ever did, which I think was actually this game. Because I've only been streaming
games.
Oh,
out of nowhere!
Samoa Joe has said it countless times. He just wants to fight. So I guess that makes King right. He's anything but laid back.
Listen, being laid back isn't going to get anybody anywhere in this business, and Samoa Joe knows that. That's why he is the way he is. He's just trying to be the absolute best. Can't fault him for that.
And now look how much I'm talking about.
Hang on.
What are you doing? Get out of the way of the camera. See, look, he was just, if I wasn't streaming, he'd be lying here, sleeping, fast asleep by now. But because I'm streaming, for some fucking reason, he has to get out of the camera.
That arm is now in an extremely compromising position.
You know, it helps, every time I'm moving, I fucking come on.
Samoa Joe with a nice reverse.
Real nice. One move after the other. It's devastating.
This is hard to watch. This is going to be bad.
Shy and not confident at all. He was when he first.
Wow, that was a wild strike. Talking about missing the target.
Yeah, it looked like it was completely out of desperation.
King, you don't have to watch Samoa Joe long to realize that he's one of the hardest hitting superstars competing today.
Yeah, he really has no nonsense, Cole. And at nearly 300 pounds, he's almost unstoppable.
I mean, I'd like to get a stream out every single day. I really would, but unfortunately.
Bad news for Samoa Joe.
Things have gone from bad to worse.
I suppose I could stream every day when I get home from work at 9 o'clock. I mean,
he's making a statement here with this attack. Looking to build momentum.
Seeking
to avoid that. A knockdown, drag out brawl, complete with a big stomp.
Man, these guys are throwing bombs. They're pulling out all the stops.
But now, I'm going on to days. On the days, you know,
to go along with Samoa Joe's hard-hitting style, he also employs a heavy dosage of submission maneuvers.
More shifts. In fact, next week, not next week. The week after, I've only got one day off. I'm doing six, so there won't be much streaming that week. Unless
now, who does a methodical pace benefit, King?
Well, I'll tell you, whenever the dominating competitor takes his time, it gives everybody a chance to catch their breath.
And I don't think I'm a bad streamer. I mean, unfortunately, because of my situation, not having the equipment to kind of stream games from
there's going to be a lot of offense in this match.
Wouldn't have it any other way. That's what I love to see. Perfectly executed.
Fuck. Oh, is he going to get it intact? No. He didn't.
It's not every day you see a man of Samoa Joe's size combine a hard-hitting, in-your-face style with a variety of submission moves.
I love it.
It's
I
that
love
combination
it.
That's going to make him a very successful superstar.
To get paid
here.
For it would be a bonus. It really would.
And Samoa Joe makes him pay in the worst way on that exchange. You got
it
from now,
really
Joe.
It would be a bonus to get paid for it because.
Hey, Cole, this could do it.
I think so.
And it's up. He got the shoulder off.
Wow.
What a display of heart and determination.
Say, like, a lot of stuff he says is bullshit, but, you know. He
Samoa Joe turns it around.
This guy's got a lot of moves.
It looks like all that punishment for the arm has finally caught up to it.
You're right about that. This isn't a good situation to be in. And if this gets much worse, it could turn into a career-threatening injury.
He's sincere when he says that he loves his friends and that he doesn't.
Seeking to avoid that.
Uh-oh, here it comes. Daniel Bryan's really getting going in there.
Healing kick combo.
Healing kick combo.
check that out. That's how effective offense can be when you're able to combine moves together. A great string of offense. You do anything you can for something to result in an advantage, and ultimately,
Daniel Bryan makes and a kick out.
And that's all that matters. This match continues.
And that's a missed opportunity to put Samoa Joe away.
And you may not have that opportunity again in this match.
Just toying with the competition a little. He's looking to fly.
I hope this turns out well. Uh-oh.
Nice move. Look out.
Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
It really would. I would be expected if the day came that I got paid for doing this. Yeah, I would
championship on the line.
Oh, you're right about that. Let's get this thing going. Who's going to be the champion?
Let's hope I should be.
It's all academic from here.
Now that's a finishing move. This thing might be all over.
What I really want to do is I want to get a PC because I want to stream games. Like, I really want to play 5 Nights at Freddy's. I know people have seen people play 5 Nights at Freddy's.
Here's the cover.
Never gets boring to me.
And he breaks the cover, forcing the referee to stop the count.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done. Just when you thought it was over. Wow.
It just doesn't get boring to watch people play. It's so amusing.
Not today. Too fast.
Let's just hope Samoa Joe's stamina can hold up. Oh, this is not going to be good. That's it. He's out. We're going to see a lot of effective moves like that in this match.
Nobody comes back from this.
What's the other special move? Rear naked choke is submission. I doubt I'm going to be able to submit him because
thus far, this has been a phenomenal championship contest. Who will win? Who's going home with the title?
And from the way things look right now, Cole, your guess is as good as mine. This has been so even, so back and forth. Who is going to win this thing? Oh my! Samoa Joe! This may very well be it. There you have it. Gets the win and remains the champion.
I'm hoping.
Well, I don't know how you can pick out highlights from that match. The whole match was highlights.
Maybe not until the end of the year or start of next year. But I'm hoping that I'm going to get even if it's just a gaming laptop, get a gaming laptop and get a webcam for it. Unless I don't know what kind of slot is in a laptop for a camera, but maybe my PlayStation camera.
Oh, there were some unbelievable highlights. What's this?
Get some kind of webcam and the software that I need to stream things like Five Nights at Freddy's and shit like that. And hopefully it's the same software that you use to do reaction with it on a PC.
One in a million is the only way to describe this match. Let's go to the highlights here.
Here's your winner and still the United States champion, Samoa Joe.
What
a match. The championship retained over some game competition.
This was an awesome match and a great win.
Wow. I didn't expect Daniel Bryan to come up short here tonight. What a matchup that was. Truly incredible.
I'm struggling to find places for my Skybox and my consoles. I legit mean, in fact, one of my consoles is actually behind my TV. That's where I had to put one. I need one. So, a gaming laptop is going to have to be the thing that I get main for some time. It's going to have to be the thing that I get. There we go. Anyway, I'm going to start spouting bullshit. So we're at 53, so yeah, it's going to be more like an hour and a half. Because I've got 3 matches left to do. And the next match is going to be the Intercontinental. Oh. hoping. I've got 40 minutes left, so that will take me to about 20 past 11. My mum doesn't come to bed before that, because then I can keep talking like this. I'd rather not whisper on the stream.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the Intercontinental Championship.
You know what I'd love to see? X-Pac return to be in the Royal Rumble. He hasn't yet. Basically since he left. Which was like, what was it, 15 years ago, 14 years ago? I mean, the only other ones are the X-Men. Rojo, Billy Gunn, Super Plate, Shawn Michaels. Well, actually, Shawn Michaels, this is how many I haven't actually to be in the Royal Rumble, and probably will never do that, but I expect to be the next one. Ooh-cha, 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 ooh-cha.
And his opponent, representing the Lucha Dragons from Mexico City, weighing in at 170 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, Kalisto.
And the passion this crowd has for this superstar is truly amazing. Just listen to him. This is what it's all about. Two competitors going head to head to decide which one is truly the best. So much anticipation, and it all right. Comes down to this.
Okay.
And there's the bell.
And just like that, we're off and running. Both men know how big this championship match is.
Well,
even in these early moments, you can feel the excitement.
Yeah,
this is going to be great.
Followed by the women's championship match, because the Tekken match took 20 minutes. And the women's championship match took 20 minutes.
We may have discovered his favorite move. You think? He seemed to use it often enough.
Yeah, there's a reversal by Kalisto.
18 minutes.
What's your analysis of Kalisto? You know what I think of X-Pac? I think of someone who can bring fans shooting to their feet in excitement, or be a boil on someone's backside. Either way, you can't deny that X-Pac makes an impact wherever he goes.
Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. That's a good sign.
Yep, there's the reversal by Kalisto.
Trying to get under his opponent's skin with this one. Surprised by a devastating kick.
Oh, man. Didn't see that one coming.
I'm not sure if there's ever been a more defiant member of the WWE roster than X-Pac. He'll fight you in the ring, in a cage, in an alley somewhere. He's as aggressive as they come.
Just when you think X-Pac can't take things any higher, he recalibrates the barometer and shocks our audience. Trust me, if you're not down with that, he's got two words for you.
This is going to leave some scars, Kalisto.
The arm has become the focal point of this attack.
Yeah, it's got a big red bullseye on it.
I'm enjoying this one.
And he fails to connect with anything that time.
That was some miss, all right. I could feel the breeze all the way over here.
He's really putting his athleticism on display here.
Somehow, he's kicking into another gear here tonight.
Watch it, watch it. There it is, the Kalisto kick.
Man, that was devastating.
Is it over?
One, two, three.
You think it would be?
Oh, you have to be on your toes when you're in the ring with Kalisto. Like most of his moves, the Salido del Sol can come out of nowhere.
Oh.
Yep, there's the reversal by Kalisto. X-Pac reverses it. Buster. That'll cause some damage. That phased him. I mean, there's no way it couldn't have.
Quick thinking to avoid that. Oh, no. We know what this is. There it is, the Salida del Sol. Adios.
Adios, amigos.
Two. Oh, damn. What a bastard.
Back of the Salida del Sol. I'd say part of the reason why it's so effective is because it's so dizzying. Kalisto's opponents barely know where they are. And before you know it, boom, they're hit with a Salida del Sol.
Yeah, and I can hardly pronounce it. But you know, in addition to being dizzying, it has to do a number on the back of your head and your neck.
Oh, oh.
Quickly into the cover with the title on the line.
There we go.
We're looking at complete domination here.
Kalisto shows us some clever offense here. Boy, he just got laid out.
Shoulders down. Championship on the line.
Kalisto's plan has got him on a roll here tonight.
Oh, and he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, you're not doing any damage with swings like that, but keep doing it. The freeze may give him a cold.
Will this be it?
I think he's got it.
King Kalisto's in the middle.
He keeps it. What a win. Well, I don't know how you can pick out highlights from that match. The whole match was highlights.
How long did that take? Well, I think I started at 54 and it's now an hour consuming for an hour and 1 minute. So, 12. No, no, fucking 12. I'm a fucking dumb 12. 54-01.
Oh, they mesmerized the WWE Universe in that match.
And fucking maths is my best subject at school.
And here's some highlights from the... Oh, they mesmerized the WWE.
Here's your winner and still the Intercontinental Champion, representing the Lucha Dragon, Kalisto.
He gets a victory here tonight. Love him or hate him, that was an incredible match.
An incredible match and a big, big victory.
I strongly suggest X-Pac go back and watch this match. There's plenty that can be learned from this loss.
It'll be interesting to see the fallout.
Lindsay has a championship. 25 weeks, same as Lita. Did he win it before? Did he? I'm trying to think when he had the championship. Was it Royal Rumble? Was it Fastlane? My fucking cat again. Lie down. Was it Fastlane? Was it only? I can't remember. I thought it wasn't Oscar Wendy, but that's going to be the one myself, and she's held it for 25 weeks, so it must have been WrestleMania. But I thought it was a Rumble, to be honest. Maybe not. Here we go. Two matches left. Now, this match next. I haven't seen either of these entrances. I'm seeing this for the first time, just like a lot of you will be. So this is going to be my legit reaction to their entrances and shit like that, because honestly, I've not even seen them, I've not even fucking YouTubed them. So, because I honestly couldn't remember who was in the Hall of Fame DLC. So, give me a second, get rid of that. Here we go. Oh, my fucking foot. Generally, I only want to stream WWE for an hour, but on occasion, like tonight, where it's taking me a little bit longer, so, oh, I think it's the end.
A handshake and a show of respect between these two superstars before they square off.
Fucking big he was.
The match is underway. Even though these two men have tremendous respect for each other, you can tell that they're both looking to pick up the win tonight.
Oh, it's no doubt about it. When that bell rings, it doesn't matter if you're competing against your best friend or...
Good clutch. Prawn hold it. What the fuck is that? Gut wrench suplex. Four.
Your worst enemy. These superstars are determined to walk out as the victors of this match. The shoulders are down.
Plenty of fight left.
What was his finishes? Dragon suplex. Dragon sleeper one.
You're right. This guy's still near 100%.
You know,
Tatsumi Fujinami's skills aside, what do you think his next move should be? I think what we're finding out here is that Tatsumi Fujinami is among the most technically gifted competitors of all time.
Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. We're going to find out who's the better competitor, that's for sure. No gimmicks here, just some good old-fashioned one-on-one action.
And that's why it's called high risk, ladies and gentlemen. Today, too fast. And just like that, this move is leading the charge.
Yeah, charge!
Ow! Ooh.
No, wait, nice reversal.
Oh, shit.
Ouch! Oh. After a move like that, he's going to need to see a chiropractor or a spine specialist, whatever he's comfortable with. No pun intended, of course.
Yeah, he's not going to be comfortable for a while.
Fujinami's technical ability is undeniable, as King mentioned, as is his submission game. I can't tell you how many times you've seen him perfectly execute a sharpshooter or figure four.
Yeah, and you know, you can't help but wonder what Bret Hart and Ric Flair think when they see the great Tatsumi Fujinami executing their signature moves.
Now back to the ring.
Oh, what a move.
An earthquake takes a thunderous spell.
Man, oh man, the ring is still shaking. If he keeps this up, this will be over in no time.
We're looking at complete domination here.
So this is a special move. Dragon's the,
Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
Fucking hell.
Tatsumi Fujinami shows us some clever offense here.
Look at Tatsumi go.
And now Tatsumi Fujinami pushing forward.
Yeah, this is a determined young man.
We're looking at complete domination here.
Shit.
Looks like the airways may be blocked. Get in there, ref.
Oh, fuck. I still can't get over the side of the earthquake. I knew he was a big guy.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs. What a reversal! And it's earthquake with the reversal.
That's pretty impressive.
Textbook snapmare.
You watch Tatsumi Fujinami compete, and you forget that he's just a few years removed from a severe back injury.
Yes, he certainly is one of the greats. But what do you expect when you're trained by the legendary Antonio Inoki?
Quick thinking to avoid that. A powerful shove here.
Yeah, he means business.
Look at it, catch him off guard.
Quick ramp count. Earthquake is certainly making his presence known now.
Incredible. And it's all earthquake now.
Cole, this may be over soon. Looking to get on a roll here.
And it was that Inoki.
Oh, an earthquake makes it pay for all that. Looking for all the glory here.
This is an interesting match.
There are a few events over the course of the year that feature more on the line than Night of Champions. You know what? There's no way that's legal. Oh, that was a hard shot. What a strike. Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. Disqualify this man. And this has got to be it.
I think so.
I just can't get over the physicality of this match. This has been brutal.
Brutal and very, very painful for these guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Night of Champions, and what an historic night it promises to be.
In the ring again. Good. Keep it in the ring, guys.
No.
This one's not over yet. We've seen plenty of people come back from being in a lot worse shape.
I'm not sure I can watch this. I don't know how much more damage he can take. This might be it.
And there's the submission hold. Will this do it?
Five. Six.
Things are. I don't believe the destruction we're seeing.
This guy's just going from one painful move to another. Wow. He's still down after that.
Is it going to get more than that point?
I'm having a hard time figuring out what they're going to do next.
Me too. I've given up even trying to figure out what they're going to do next.
With all that build-up, it's sad to see it end like that. This one is way gone.
Really,
and here's just some of the action we saw during the match.
In real life, and they don't want someone being a loser. They always... they always have it like that, so no one looks weak. And that's what I kind of wanted to say. I didn't want, you know, their face to look weak. Because
they mesmerized the WWE Universe in that match.
That's what I had to talk about.
Oh, they threw everything they had.
Oh, that was a match for the record books.
The WWE Universe will be buzzing about this one for a while.
Here's your winner, Tatsumi Fujinami.
He gets a victory here tonight. Love him or hate him, that was an incredible match.
An incredible match and a big, big victory.
Right from the opening bell, Earthquake really looked lost out there tonight.
Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.
Should be about right. Tatsumi Fujinami, one of the branch fans, Earthquake, like a positive rival, continues as a respect for each of the players.
To rock around, to rock.
Oh. Nope, not yet. TLC. Fucking heartburn. I hate it. It's not that it's painful. It's just, it's horrible. Anyway. Sting versus The Undertaker. Should be left
the following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
I could have done, but I didn't want to. Thanks. Magnificent. Fuck it. Let's watch.
Introducing the challenger from every man's nightmare, weighing in at 250 pounds, the man called Sting.
Let's watch the magnificence. I don't know how to fucking say that word. We all have to put words we should have to say. Magnificence. Doesn't sound like that. Now, if you watched my say quickly the result from this and stick to a point. If you watched my last stream, which was the SummerSlam one, you know that it was to one side match from the token. I'm hoping this one's not really safe. Both fucking cameras worked on the camera. Unfortunately, this is the second camera, so I can remove fucking hands from the camera as well. Unless I'm just ignoring a setting where I can get both of them to work out. Because that one, right, I'm covering it, doesn't cover it. That one does. I don't understand what. As I said, unless there's some kind of I'm actually gonna check it after this. Fucking camera. Yeah. I'm actually gonna check it after the stream to check if there is a setting that I haven't looked at. I'm still not happy with that.
So much anticipation. This is gonna be one for the record books.
Few superstars have ever achieved the level of popularity that Sting has gained.
Well, that's because few superstars have been able to replicate the career Sting has had.
Oh, old school already. As I get pulled down. Nope, I'm getting pulled down. Old school.
And so taking a look at Sting, any thoughts come to mind?
You know, when people think of the unmakes the cover, and he escapes with a kick out.
Sting's got the energy of a young buck. Man, it's like he's channeling the 1987 Stinger.
There may be no stopping him. Take on The Undertaker and pay-per-views is a great one that some fans may have forgotten. We don't get to where we are today without that historic debut at the 1990 Survivor Series.
And that's right. And I understand when fans think of Undertaker and pay-per-views that they think of WrestleMania. But thinking back to his WWE debut at the 1990 Survivor Series, that was awesome. And you don't get to the legend today without that historic debut.
The dead man's power is simply supernatural. Oh, and he eats the canvas. Moves like that can upset your opponent more than hurt them. Just trying to goad his opponent into making a mistake here. When this guy's on, look out.
The Undertaker, what a counter that was.
Ladies and gentlemen, this one-on-one match is for the championship. Do not change the channel. Do not go to the fridge. Text your friends. We may be witnessing history here.
Playing mind games.
Yeah.
A little intimidation there.
Wow, that might have broken his jaw.
If you're such a prolific striker like The Undertaker, you can create your own momentum. When you're as dominant as The Undertaker, you can unleash the flame.
That's a slam. Ain't gonna be long now.
Right. His minutes are numbered.
King, you touched on it from the
shoulders up. And the match continues. I love this. This is why Sting is considered a legend. Man, that one rocked him.
Going to the top. High risk.
I'm not sure if he knows where he is right now. Oh, what's he going to do to follow that up?
Oh, that wild strike found nothing but empty air that time.
Man, that's what you call swinging for the fences and missing.
A part of me will always remember the bloodshed during the Monday Night War with WCW and that the company tried to put WWE out of business. I don't like Sting, but he has got heart.
Sting shot to the mat.
That's just going to upset him. Watch it.
Undertaker preparing the grave.
Quick pin. Can he do it?
Maybe. With the championship at stake, you know these superstars will get everything they have to win here tonight.
Oh, that goes without saying, Cole. The WWE Championship, it's what it's all about here in the WWE. Every superstar wants to be the champion, and tonight's match is no exception.
Submission locked in, and this might be it.
This is not the position you want to be in.
And there's the release. What's going to happen now?
I'm scared to ask.
Wow, that was a wild strike. Talk about missing the target.
Yeah, it looked like it was completely out of desperation.
Oh, shit, he lost.
Today, too fast.
Oh, shit, he's doing his own version of the team.
Oh, look out! Human bones can be crushed after sustaining impact like that. Somebody better call it over.
Hey, the shoulders are down!
And he kicks out.
And he lives to fight again. The dead man is still in this.
He's making a statement here with this attack. Quick thinking to avoid that.
Is this it?
We're looking at complete domination here. Looks like he's pinpointing the back.
Oh, gosh. Hey, what do you want for your last meal? Look out! Look out!
Oh, I think this man needs business.
He got him!
Oh, wow. Woo, a little showboating going on here.
Look at this! He's just barely moving! I'm not sure he can get back to his feet. Taker relentless!
Not today, too fast!
What a reversal!
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Taker on a major roll here!
Great match here, but if you missed any of the matches from this week, go to WWE.com to catch up on all the action.
I go to WWE.com all the time to catch up on the Divas. There may be no fighting out of this.
Here we go. Here we go. He's hanging on for dear life.
Great hold being applied.
And he lets him out.
Well, he might have been losing some of his grip there anyway. He probably figured it would be better to release.
There's the pan. Ken is upon a kick out. And a kick out.
The kick out's all that's saving. This match goes on. Oh, there is no quit in this man tonight. He's showing no signs of letting up.
Sometimes that's all it takes.
Wow, he's still down after that.
He thinks he has it. Undertaker connecting there with a good shot.
Not a lot of spring left in his step right now. Look out what's going on here.
It all comes down to this. One-on-one for the championship. This is where legacies are born and dreams are shattered. Here's the pin. Title on the line.
And that title may change hands. The Undertaker has defending the title decisively. Hold on. What's he doing? Oh, no! He's got a chair!
Don't do this. Come on, don't do this!
Not a great way to win the match, but there we are. I hope you enjoyed my stream. We'll be doing another one very, very soon. I'm quite shocked at the just healed and he's still got his shit. That was actually interesting. No, he's still got fear there, but at the second of the fight. He's ending to the water potential match. They have got one more match and it's probably gonna be inside of heaven or something. So that's gonna be a match to watch, so make sure you tune in next time. Next episode, Hell in the Cell. Episode 4, Hell in the Cell. Thank you for having this episode. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.